All right, here we go.
Relay testing for those who work for them. That is AI.
Milo show is here today. You don't want to miss a single word they say. Bringing you founders from a near and far. Listen as they tell you now just who they are. Listen to their stories and how they care. Just 3 minutes, how they're doing well. Telling us what it's all about today. And how they are loving that old blessed away on passive. It's a here to stay on passive. There's just no better way. Listen to the Julie and the Milo show. So then you can be the very first to know. On passive, it's a here to stay. Julie and Milo show is coming your way Saturday. On passive. Oh yeah. Julie. All right.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Julie and Milo Show. Today is December 18, 2021. It's such a pleasure for Milo and I to have you here with us. Today is all about season greetings. We're talking about Christmas. You do have 3 minutes to share what you wish to share, anything about Christmas. If you're not celebrating Christmas, we welcome you are here as well. And we'd love to hear about what you are doing during this season as well. So as I can say, you know, we're gonna have a great time today. Please remember, please keep your mic mute, because when someone is singing or when, as you can see, there was one mic open and Milo started singing. It is completely cut him off, right? Because it does that. That's Zoom, right? That's why we're looking forward to our product. But today, it's a fun day today. We are going to have fun today, and it's all about the season greetings that we'd like you to hear today. So please raise your hands if you like to sing, if you like to speak, 3 minutes. But I'm gonna send it over to Milo, and Milo has a treat for all of us here. All right, Milo.
All right, thank you, Julie, and it isn't a Zoom thing. That's actually an internet thing. It's called interlatency. So there's no way that anyone can sing, two people sing at the same time. Now you can do it if you record and sing, but you can't do it if you're on a Zoom call or you're even on any internet. But I did ask Mr. Ashmafaro if we would be able to do that. He did tell me that we would as soon as it's available, but it's not available yet because the speed of the internet will not handle that. So if you have a mic open, know that if you've got a mic open when someone is singing, you're messing up their song, and you're going to end up, when it's recorded, you're going to come on and it's going to show you, you know, instead of the person singing, if you cough or something like that. So just be conscious and make sure your mics are muted when someone sings. So I'm going to start it out and I'm going to show you how I do. So I loaded in a song called Blue Christmas, and I haven't sang this thing in years and years, but the words are right on the screen, the music is playing, and so I'm going to try it. So here we go. Y'all ready? A little Blue Christmas for you. Julie, can you, okay, great. Uh-oh, hold on, I'm sorry. I turned my speaker off, I forgot. I gotta turn my speaker back on. So if you have a speaker, just hook into your speaker and then you'll be able to do it. Let me go back and. Sorry about that. All right, here we go. I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue just thinking about you. Decorations I just had to change the words a little bit, you know.
Fantastic, Milo. That was so cool. Of course, we're not feeling blue at all.
That's right. So see how easy that was, everyone? It's just you just sit there and sing, you know.
Yeah. All you have to do is have the phone or the device. Use one on Zoom and the other you look at and just sing, right?
Sing away. That's it. That's right. All right.
We have Holly Cherry in the house.
Oh, all right. There she is. Santa.
Hey, guys. Hi. Sorry. See, I'm getting ready to go out, so that's why I put up my hand right away. Merry Christmas, everybody. I can talk about Christmas. Oh, my goodness. Every day to me is Christmas. The number one reason why I love Christmas is because we are celebrating and remembering the birth of Jesus Christ. My Lord and Savior.
Love it.
Okay. Even though, you know, there's Christmas trees, there's presents, everybody's shopping and everything. But the most important is because of Jesus Christ. And I just want to say Merry Christmas to everybody. I'm about to go shopping now and I can't really sing. Milo, you have an awesome. You should be doing the concert for the next 3 hours if we hear 3 hours. But I will be listening. And I just want to say, thank you so much, Milo and Julie, again, for everything you do for us. So Merry Christmas. I will be listening. I'm stepping up, but I'll be listening.
All right. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you as well, Polly.
Thank you. Love you guys. Thank you.
All right. Next up, we have Mr. Jim Bell, come on down.
There, can you hear me?
We can hear you.
Very good.
Okay, good. I got an announcement to make for everybody.
All right.
Okay, so first thing is, I'm trying to fix my camera here. I put a song in the chat there for you, Milo. You can pull that up if you want to play that. It's a friend of mine who does... He's a recording artist, and he's got a Christmas song. He's got a Christmas song here. You can play that for everybody, and you just can subscribe to his channel if you like it. But this is the announcement. On Thursday, this coming Thursday, at 3:30 p.m., corporate Zoom, it's going to be an ONPASSIVE Christmas special, and there is going to be a special guest. We don't know if the person will be there or not. That's yet to be determined. But Marty is going to be helping me host it with Pam Turner and Cedric Flowers. And it's just going to be just Christmas. It's all about. And Santa Claus is going to be there. Just wanted to let everybody know that. So watch for the link. It'll be posted later in the week.
All righty. Thank you, Jim.
Yep.
All right, Thursday. You said Thursday. Watch for the link with Mr. Jim Bell. All right, and next up we have William from Canada. Come on down, William.
Yeah, hello, and Merry Christmas, everyone. I'm want to have a suggestion for people, on Amazon, I can order hot chocolate with marshmallows, and you can order the small candy canes. So if everybody wants to celebrate with me, order some and have a hot chocolate with marshmallows, and stir the candy cane and have a wonderful marshmallow day. This is a celebration for all founders.
And supported myself, but I think unfortunately there are unintended consequences.
William, hold on, let me meet Bruce. Perfect, William. I know you're a marshmallow man. So thank you for letting us know. All right, up next, Tony, you have your hands up. Your hand up.
Oh, hello. Hi, everybody. Nice to see everyone here. Thank you, Julie. I was wondering if I could sing the song, the Christmas song. Is that all right?
Absolutely. Yes. Yeah. Go ahead, Tony.
Okay, great. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dress up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loading lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 9 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. So I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to Christmas. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Wow, that was lovely, Tony. Thank you so much for coming on and share that. That was beautiful. That was very lovely. Thank you.
Nice job, Tony.
Yeah, yes, it is. It was really very soothing. All right, Curtis, if you would please unmute your mic. Curtis, your mic is muted. Try one more time.
There you go. I had a problem come up. I'll be back in just a little bit. I'll get back on later.
Okay. All right, Curtis. We'll see you soon. All right, Okan Umana, good to see you here. Please unmute your mic.
Thank you very much. I just want to say
what you doing?
Greetings.
I did.
My beloved and respected members of ONPASSIVE, and most specifically, greetings to you, my beloved and respected Julie and Milo, for all the services that you have rendered to humanity. I just want to wish you that there will be peace, love, and harmony among you, my people. Peace profound. Julie, I will leave you a message on your Facebook site. Thank you, everybody, for everything you have done for one another. Because love is the foundation of all creation. And ONPASSIVE was founded on this principle. And we have to stay on the principle, love, help, and serve one another as ourselves. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Okan. Very nice. All right, next up we have Christoph Hein. Christoph Hein, unmute yourself and come on down.
Yes, hello. Thank you very much. I'm from Germany, and I'm very surprised because you already celebrate Christmas. And in our country, we never do this before the 24th of December. Before, it's the time before Christmas, but the real celebration starts at 24th, and then the 25th is the first Christmas day, and 26th the second. This is the big holy time. But I like it very much, and thank you very much for this courage man who sang here his Christmas song. It's very beautiful, it has been, yes. Thank you for this. Actually, I don't have questions, but I wanted to say this, and I'm very amazed to find you here in such a good position and in a good mood and smile. And this is my big, wonderful family from ONPASSIVE. You find it around the world. These are wonderful people. So I enjoy to be with you. I hope you don't complain that I sneak into your room, but we are family. So I just say, I'm a member as well. I want to visit you. And also you are welcome when I have the chance to open the door for you. Okay, thank you very much.
Absolutely.
Go ahead, Julie.
Absolutely, Christoph. It's so good to hear you and have you here with us. We welcome you. If this is your very first time you're joining us, we're yes. doing this every Saturday, rain or shine. We do this every Saturday, and we are just gathering together to share the fun, the chat, the laughter, and all the gifts that we all receive in ONPASSIVE. And that's what the Julie and Milo is for. So you are welcome here anytime.
Thank you very much for this invitation. Yes.
Thank you so much. Mm-hmm.
Yes, thank many you. Things going on the ONPASSIVE apparatus. It's so great. I got addicted to this. I must always go into the back office, and it works real well in my where I am. Although my computer is already old, but it works. So I have to be careful with it. Too much data I cannot work with. So sometimes I have to start new, but it's okay. So nice. And what a big and wonderful thing we have. You'd never find this again. This quality of page and advertisement.
Thank you. It's
so great. So I'm very curious about what's going to happen the next time, the next coming days. It's certainly going to be very exciting, and we must behave ourselves, because ONPASSIVE people, you can already recognize them. They cannot stop smiling. They always smile because of what is coming. We always have to smile. It's our faith, but it's a wonderful one.
All righty. Thank you, Crystal. All right.
Glad to be with you. Thank you very much. It's okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right, Julie, back to you.
Yes. Absolutely, Milo. Thank you so much. Thank you, Christoph, for being here with us. You know, everyone, Christoph has said that Christmas doesn't start until the 24th. And I do agree with him. And I do agree with everything that we share here. But I also say, to me, Christmas is every day to me. And my daughters and I, our family, if we want to buy a gift for our kids, we'll buy it. You know, it's not really Christmas, to be honest with you. Up until now, the 18th of December already, there's no Christmas tree, no Christmas laying around in our house yet. It's just because the season itself, to me, Christmas is,
Julie, what does Christmas mean to you?
Oh, Milo, Christmas, basically, it's a season of sharing, it's a season of love, of peacefulness, right? When it comes to the cold weather outside, you're in the house, you're with your family. It's just that peacefulness inside, that joy inside of me. Absolutely, Christmas is all about Jesus was born, and it's just that peaceful. But then when you are looking at the manger, when Mary has to go through so many steps, so many ways, to get to the point, to the manger, and then deliver Jesus. I mean, it's like that whole entire scene, just the narrations of it, the image of it. To me, it's joy and peace and love. So that's what Christmas means to me. And I believe it is a time for me and many other people actually look at inside of themselves and ask themselves, do we live Christmas every day, or it's just a season that we are doing? You know, it's all about, and today before we leave, I'm going to play a song that really means to us, to me. And I do hope that when that song plays, you kind of see the journey that it's walking. And if you take that journey, right, and then you compare that with the journey that many of us are going, walking and on passive, I think it has some meaning to it. So, you know, just simple. Christmas is joy, love, peacefulness.
Wonderful words, Julie. Thank you very much. It's nice. I can feel
it. What about? Go ahead, Christoph. Did you want it to say something?
I appreciate very much your nice words, what you said. Yeah, so I could just see you and your family enjoying the time. But as I noticed, you come from California, but this is a warm country, or are you living in the north?
I am living in the south of California, so it's beautiful weather outside. And I say this doesn't mean that I rub it off or anyone's that's having snow and stuff like that. I do understand, and I don't think I can actually feel the coldness and the weather outside, but I do share that with you. And I want to send the warm weather here to you. I hope I could be the Tinkerbell sometime to just flying around and just sprinkle all the warm dust to you. But my prayer of safety and warmth go out to everyone that doesn't have the weather that I'm currently have right now in California.
You do very well. Thank you.
Thank you, Christoph.
I appreciate very much the work you're always doing. I saw you many times in other webinars, and I said, Mamma mia, how much work you are doing and what you do for the ONPASSIVE family as such. It's a great work. Thank you very much. I must say
I appreciate your kind word. Thank you. All right.
I haven't seen Milo for such long, so I'm very happy to see Milo the first time. Yes, and it's nice, and he has always such a nice smile. And now I heard him the first time now in live speaking. Thank you as well.
Lovely.
It's a good Christmas time now. Thank you.
Lovely. Thank you so much. All right. I do see Karina, but I wanted to ask Milo a little bit. Karina, I'll get back with you really quick. Milo, what does Christmas mean to you? And I know you love Christmas, so.
I do. Julie, I love Christmas. I do love Christmas. You know, one of the things that Christmas means to me, is I grew up very blessed. Okay. I have been so blessed in my life. And you hear me say it all the time. There's no one in this world that's more blessed than I've been. But I think sometimes at Christmas time, you know, I do, you know, realize that it's Jesus's birth and all that. And but myself, I like to think of sometimes the less fortunate, you know, the people that are homeless out there, the people that, you know, don't have anything. And I think it's a time at Thanksgiving time, we also do it. But at Christmas time, you know, it kind of tugs at my heart a little bit, you know, because it's the cold of winter. And of course, you don't have winter down in California, but if you're from Michigan, it's cold up there. And we used to get snow up there, you know. And when you think about people that's maybe out on the street or not, don't have stuff to eat, a place to live and stuff like that, it grips your heart a little bit, you know. And so I like to, at Christmas time, encourage everyone to remember the less fortunate, you know. Remember them that maybe don't have what you've got. I know I did a song called Pretty Paper, and it dawned on me once, I'll tell you a little about that. I'd seen some homeless people, and it dawned on me one day when I, 15 years later, no, it was actually 21 years later, I 85, I'd seen like my first homeless people, because we didn't really have homeless that I knew of in our city, you know. But when I went to a big city in Annapolis and I seen these people sitting on the side of the street, and you know, it didn't, I thought, boy, how sad. That was in 1985. In 2006, I was sitting in my living room in my brand new home with my grand piano. And, you know, we had a Christmas tree on the first floor, one in the basement and one upstairs. And I looked over at the Christmas tree and the packages were stacked up halfway up the tree, it seemed like. And I was singing Pretty Paper, and the words hit me. Pretty Paper is a song about a guy sitting on the street that's homeless, and he's watching the people go in and out, and they're getting the pretty paper and they're wrapping their pretty paper, you know. And that's what it's about. And it's about, do you think of me, you know? What about me? I'm sitting out here, you know, homeless. And I know you know, we can say, hey, some people, you know, they don't help themselves. And that's true. But the truth of it is, with ONPASSIVE, we're going to be able to help everybody. So Christmas at ONPASSIVE is going to be wonderful, you know, and maybe not this year. You might not be able to give out that much. But next year, man, I can't wait to be passing out cards that says, hey, just call this number. I'll put you in. You know what I'm saying? And you don't have, you know, if you do something, okay. If you don't, it's okay too. I'm going to bless you, you know, and I think that's what Christmas is about. It's about a giving spirit.
Absolutely. Okay. Thank you so much, Milo. I'm going to call on Karina first to see that she's on the phone. Karina, are you ready to speak? All right. I'm going to wait for her. you know, Milo, yeah. You had mentioned about thinking of the unfortunate. It is absolutely true. And wanted to everyone to reflect back to what happened on Thursday when Mr. Ashmufar were sitting down with a group of Michigan Michigan Angels, and we're talking about the homelessness out there. As you can see, it is everywhere in the world, right? Homelessness is not just in Michigan, it's not just in California, it's everywhere in the world. And it is something that we all, if you haven't thought so, this is something that we all need to think about it. How can we contribute into helping them, you know, out of that situation? So we are here everywhere around the world. I believe this is something that is important that we all think about. And if you haven't seen that Thursday meeting with Mr. Ash, it's a very short one. It's in the back office. We all could go out there and share it a little bit. All right, Karina.
It's actually Tuesday, Julie.
Is it Tuesday? Okay.
It was the day before, and then we had my party, which,
man. Yes, you're right. I can't keep track of that. Thank you so much, Milo. And it's in the back office, and Marty posted. So
is that the one with the Ash and Peter Scher and at the restaurant and that? Yes. That was really good. I was jealous.
and Joyce Hicks is here with us. She's coming in the room, so she'll share that a little bit. But yeah, go ahead, please, Karina Lenz.
Hi, guys. Yeah, Merry Christmas. It's a little early, but yeah. I just wanted to come on and say hi to y'all. And thank you again for this every Saturday, Julie and Milo. I usually have around the same time. I have a prior engagement every Saturday at the same time. So I just said, I'm going to this today. So it's like I never get a chance to come and see you guys. So yes, I said no today. I'm going on this and that's all there is to it. So anyways, yeah, thank you so much for letting me be here. And Christmas, you know, I just want to say Christmas is different, I guess, for everybody around the world. But for me, it's definitely about family and love and Jesus, his birthday and whatnot. That's what it is to me. And I ask kids what Christmas is about, and they say presents. And I just kind of think it's so cute because that's what they know, right? It's adorable. But anyway, yeah, I love you guys very much. And I just wanted to come on and say hi to y'all and say Merry Christmas. And we're going to have the greatest new year there ever is going to be. So, and great singing, Milo. I mean, that's awesome. And Tony, I mean, hey, good for you for coming on, because that's hard. Like, I mean, just singing in front of people. I don't know. It's almost like I need, you know, a couple ones of these to get calm, but I don't even drink. Anyways, I love you guys. Have a good day.
Thank you, Karina. I love you too. Have a great Christmas. All right, Milo.
Okay. What are we doing?
We're calling Eric Kessler coming out. Eric.
Oh, my God. I didn't see it. Oh, Eric. Hey, come on down, Eric. Sorry.
That's all right.
Hey, everybody. How's everybody doing?
Good.
Great, Eric.
I'm sorry I'm late. I just actually saw this just now, so I'm glad I got on, didn't miss it altogether. I'd like to share a little Christmas story with you from my childhood that was actually a miracle. I don't even remember how old I was, elementary school, whatever. But my mother pretty much raised me and my brother and my sister by herself, and didn't have a lot of money. And we wanted a Christmas tree, and she wanted to get us one, but she could only spare, and it wasn't even a spare, she had to sacrifice for that $5. So we went out to look for a Christmas tree, and we got to the lot, and my mom asked the guy, back then you could get a Christmas tree around $15, $20, something like that. And she asked him, what's the cheapest one he's got? And he told her it would be $15, and she said, well, I only got five. And he said, well, I'm sorry, lady, I can't sell you one for that. It's not my lot. I just work here. She goes, do you have anything? And he said, well, I have this tree over here. And we walked over, and there's this little skinny tree, all frozen and everything. And she said, well, how much? And he told her, well, I'll give it to you for $5. He said, that's best I can do. She goes, I'll take it. So we took it home. And put it in the stand with water and everything. And the next day we got up and that tree just went like that. And it was the prettiest Christmas tree we ever had. I mean, it was shape perfect. It was just green, smell good. I mean, it was amazing. And I will never forget that for the rest of my life. I mean, God provides. And that was just a wonderful thing. So that's my Christmas story. Thanks for listening.
Awesome, Eric. Thank you so much for joining us. Go ahead, Milo.
That was beautiful. All right, come on down. Let's see. Lisa McBride. Lisa's probably going to sing for us, right, Lisa? Yeah.
No, not this time. Maybe sometime.
All right.
More like play my guitar rather than sing.
All right.
I just wanted to say that when people have trouble coming on here to sing and stuff, to just appreciate what Leadership Council went through when they started their Zooms and their information and to lead us and the nerves that it took to do that and to come out here and help us every day. So I just wanted to say thank you and Merry Christmas. And if you guys keep up these stories too much longer, I'm going to have to turn my camera off so I can cry, okay? So keep not too sad. Christmas is awesome, and we are all blessed, and I want to thank everybody here, and I'll torture you some other time with a song, maybe.
All right.
Thank you, Lisa. We appreciate that you are here. Yes, Christmas is a joy, but at the same time, you know, if you're spending Christmas alone, it can be, you know, lonely, right? So reach out. Don't stay alone. You have the whole entire family. I'm not saying just to Lisa, but I'm saying to everybody. You know, we are all here as a family. Just know that you have a million and 100,000 family member around you, right? So we mentioned about Christmas, but I do know and I do understand that there are other people are not celebrating Christmas. It's okay too. We would love to hear what do you do and what's your memory about the season, right? The season that is coming. And then I see that Joyce Hicks is here and I do hope that she'll raise her hand and kind of share with us the experience she met with Mr. Ash. And I know she did share it in the corporate, but it's okay. She has other feelings she hasn't shared, right? So I'd love to hear that as well. Up next, I see Willow Griffith is hands is up.
Thank you, Julie. Coming to stop in today to talk to my two favorite people on ONPASSIVE. I get very teary-eyed when I think, Julie, how much I love you. I want to tell you a Christmas story because I was born in the Depression. And I had a mother that was unbelievably strong. We lived on a farm, very, very austere surroundings. We didn't have much money. And during the Depression, many, many people from all over the United States were coming across the property where we lived. And they were in terrible straits. I was very, very young and I'd hang on to my mother's skirts. And I was so afraid because we didn't know who they were and they were all dirty. But my mother, who didn't have much to begin with, would start the week before Christmas and she'd make sandwiches. Just bread and butter and ham, because my father raised all of our food. And she would prepare them for the people crossing across it was like a railroad track prior to our property, and they'd come up the railroad tracks in swarms with little kids and kids my age. And I'd see them and they'd have rags, literally they were clothed in rags. And it left such an impression upon me. I know that we read Steinbeck's book, you know, about the grapes of wrath. And really, truly, you could not, it was embedded in my memory. And when I see the homeless now, and my little mother was 5'1", she'd stand out there with her dog and her little table, and she'd have these sandwiches, and she'd give them away one by one to everybody, and nobody would take two. They'd take one and they'd thank her. And the children were the same way. No one was greedy. And I remembered my mother saying, this is what Christmas is about. This is what Christ would do. And throughout my lifetime, Christmas for our children was really important, that we'd pick a family that we knew were really having hard times. And my children would give up two of their presents to donate to the family. And the night before Christmas, we'd get in the car and we'd drive to the home and we'd sneak out and we'd put all of the presents that my children had put together and my husband and I, and we'd put them on the porch. And we'd knock on the door and run away. And we'd hide in the car and watch them when they come out. And that was the most memorial thing my children remember about Christmas, is the giving to those that have little. So I'm with you, Julie, when I think of Christmas. I lost my daughter, my oldest daughter, at Christmas time. And when she crossed over, I thought, I would forever have that memory in my mind, you know, of losing my daughter. But no, the memories I have about Christmas was my beautiful mother. And she was beautiful. She was, my father's Native American, my mother was Irish, and she was gorgeous. And she was a teacher, and she taught people in their homes and in little small schools all across the prairie. She taught the Native Americans after I met my dad. And they weren't allowed to marry because in South Dakota at that time, you did not marry Native Americans. It was against the law. And so they had to sneak around to be together, and then they had to run away and come to California in order to get married. And so their story is really marvelous to hear, how they had a Model T Ford and they smuggled two of their friends with them across the border. But there are things about Christmas that are forever etched in my mind. And my daughter come home, she moved back to be with us here. And she says, you know, Mama, we need to find a family. She says, because I miss that tradition that we all had when we were growing up, you know. And I said, they're everywhere. You know, it's not just one family that's having a hard time. There's many, many, many other families. And no matter how little you have, there's always something you can give away. And so I urge you to do that this season. And especially with these lovely people we're around here with ONPASSIVE, we're going to have such an opportunity to be the givers we've always wanted to in our hearts. And I'm so anxious to begin with Oh Bless that I can hardly stand it. I can't hardly wait. It's going to be, you know, fantastic. My daughter and I were planning about some of the projects that we wanted to fulfill. And especially during the Christmas seasons, you know, when people were so desperate when I was growing up. It was an entirely different kind of desperation, however, than what you see on the streets now. So I'm really anxious to hear from Joyce and what they're doing in Michigan, because if it is going to be as successful as I know it's going to be watching those beautiful people, how they come out and stole your heart. That's what we need in order to start a movement that like we want to start is people like Joyce. And the other lady, I was so impressed with her, how many years she has been contributing. You know, she was even honored by the United States Congress, I believe. And so unaffected by it. She was marvelous. Joyce, I light my candles for you now, and I hope that you will continue to let us know the progress so we can emulate your success across the world. But thank you for listening to me, to my reminiscence. Christmas is about reminiscing, I think all the good times we remember.
Thank you, Willow.
I appreciate you all.
Thank you very much. We love you. Thanks for your kind words. And that was beautiful. All right. Next up, we have Mr. Tony Monk. Come on down, Tony.
Oh, thank you, Milo. I wanted to apologize to you and Julie. It's been this is the first time I've been on your show, and I'm ashamed. I really am. I should have been on your show a long time ago. You guys are fantastic. I love both of you. Julie actually brought up a really good point about Christmas. Christmas is all about unconditional love. It's about connecting all our hearts together and helping each other out. I've got family, but they're 4,000 miles away. My partner's in a hospital, so Christmas is going to be a lonely one. But I have a family. It's called ONPASSIVE, and I'm grateful for that. I was wondering if I could sing another song. Is that okay?
Yes.
One more. It's White Christmas.
Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Ah.
the wise Christmas, just like the ones I used to know. Where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. With every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. With every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white.
Your mic is muted, Milo. Thank you, Tony. Thank you so much for entertaining us with another Christmas song. Thank you. All right.
Tony, sorry about that. Mamodu, come on down, Mamodu.
Hello, Miss Julie, Mr. Milo, and everybody. Good afternoon. Thank you all for what you're doing. You know, I don't have much to say. I just call to use your medium to thank God, first of all, for the life, for the health that he gave me throughout. And a special thanks to Mr. Ash, you know, for making my life purposeful, meaningful. You know, I was born in Sierra Leone with a large family. I have a sibling of 12, and out of those 12, we have my
Mamodu, I'm going to turn off your video, okay, because it come in very laggy, so that you can continue.
Do that.
It come in very laggy, so we don't know what you say. I'm going to turn off your video. Please continue.
Okay, I already turned it off myself. No, I was just telling you, I said, first of all, I will use your meeting. Thank God for giving me health and long life. And a special thank you to Mr. Ash for making my life meaningful and purposeful. You know, I was born in Sierra Leone, West Africa, and from a large family, a sibling of 12, and out of those 12 siblings, My father had over 200 grandkids. So all of them, they rely on me here. So since I came to this country, I've been working 2 shifts every day. But now that I met on passive and I know my responsibility will be fulfilled. And thank you very much for helping me understand my opportunity. You know, I call this company opportunity because I've never dreamed of it. And I know my life will change and I will be able to use it to solve my family problem and my country, Sierra Leone. So I'm just thankful and I'm very much appreciative. You know, although I work every day, but I also try to make sure I join your show because it enlightens me and it gives me more courage and wisdom. So thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mamodu.
You're welcome.
I appreciate you very, very much. I remember meeting you in Maryland. It was such a lovely time we had there, and I appreciate you so much. You always show up for me. I appreciate that very much. It means a lot to me. Thank you, Mamodu. All right, up next, I'd like to introduce to you Joyce Hicks. I would love to, Joyce to take some time and share with us her experience and give us some of the important information about, you know, homelessness that you've discussed for us to basically think about what we are moving forward when the apple comes.
Thank you, Julie, and thank you, Milo. Hello, everyone, and this is just an awesome opportunity to be here, and thank you for letting me speak. You guys were so, just so awesome. So, I love everybody in ONPASSIVE. I love ONPASSIVE and everything about it. And Willow, you are just such a blessing. Oh my gosh, you had me in tears. So thank you so much. You are just a beautiful, beautiful person. Everyone is, but Willow is just like that special person. So thank you. And Tony, you have a great voice. Thank you as well. And if you guys were talking about Christmas, and you know, Christmas is to me is about family and friends and just about giving. And like Julie said, Christmas is every day. You know, because we give every day, we share, just loving people. And I think Milo said too, we know it's about God and Christmas and how he came and everything, but it's about people and giving. And as we were just talking about giving, and we were in the meeting with Ash, and that was just totally awesome. It was just one of the best things that could have ever happened. I just can't, sometimes still have to pinch myself and say, is this real? Did this really happen? Just meeting him in person. And not only is he just an intelligent person, he has a big heart. He's giving, he's funny, he's hilarious. And he just made us feel so welcomed and at home. And it was just something that I will never forget, that I will cherish forever. He just cares about people. He has a heart of gold and he has a big heart. So we just had, you know, just such a good time. And it was one thing was so important about Mr. Ash Bafar is that he wanted to hear about us. I mean, he talked to us and he wanted to hear our ideas and, you know, who we were and what we were about. And then he shared his family with us. That was just awesome. His wife and his children. And that, like everyone has said, that Omar is just something else. So just to be able to be in the presence of all of the founders. And it was Wilhelmina was the one that you were talking about that has done so much work with the homeless. And, you know, it not only has ONPASSIVE changed my life, but it has changed the lives of so many. And with this project that we talked about, the angels, it will be able to change the lives of so many people as we were talking about giving. And that's what it's all about. It's like being able to provide, not only being a, he says, you teach a, well, the Bible says that as well too. You give a man a fish, he'll eat for a day, but you teach a man to fish and he'll eat for a lifetime. So that's what the Homeless Project is going to be about, teaching people to fish and teaching them to be sufficient and teaching them to provide for themselves, not only giving them a shelter, but to give them a tool and a vehicle and a revenue to be able to do so. And with ONPASSIVE, we'll be able to do that. So it ended up being like everyone started to share their ideas with each other. And it ended up being not just about homelessness, but about what was important to you. So we talked about, you know, women and children, pregnancy, giving to schools and giving to so many entities out there that when we bring this together, we would see this all in one big umbrella. So it'd be like a one-stop place. You would have this huge facility and everyone would come there for whatever need there is. We would be able to meet that need through ONPASSIVE and through OBLESS. So it's just like it just started to get bigger and bigger. The ideas were just so awesome that we shared. I mean, I wish I could share everything. I can't recall everything that we shared, but it was great. And everyone's ideas were so important. They were just so big that it became just a project. And as we say, it's more than a project. It's more than a business. It's a movement. So this movement of homelessness is going to be grand. And once we meet again and we're setting the ground rules and setting up everything up, and it'll just continue to spread and it'll just be like that ripple effect. And we'll be able to try. Our goal is to end homelessness, that no person should be without a home, without food, without shoes, without anything. So ASHA's Heart is for Humanity, and it just caught to everyone, and it was just like a wildfire. We just had such an awesome time, and the project will be, it'll be great. And so, and I know that everyone has a heart for the homeless, and then that becomes our heart, is that, as Milo said, living in Michigan, I know Julia in California is wonderful. I've been there before. I have family there and it's a beautiful place. And, you know, it gets really hot too. But in Michigan, like right now we have an ice storm. So, and my heart is thinking about the people that are out there without a home. So they're sitting on benches and they are under a box or they have a blanket, and it's not only raining, but it's sleeting. So there's ice and rain and snow combined together. And so, you know, not only are they cold, but they're wet. I mean, and they just don't have anything. So with this project, we'll be able to help those people and for them to find shelter, you know, and just be able to bless so many people around, not just in the United States, but around the world. We'll be able to touch. It's global. I mean, I know you all know that ONPASSIVE is global, but this will be a global thing that we can help so many people around the world. And that is just so important. And I'm going to stop talking because I'll just keep talking on and on. And if there's any other specific thing that you want, just let me know and I can try and answer it. But it was phenomenal. It was just an unforgettable time.
Thank you, Joyce. So I got to ask you, now I've met Ash personally, and now you have. Tell me, is there a different? I mean, when you meet the guy, can you feel the passion? Can you feel the love coming?
Oh my gosh, you can feel the love. You can feel the passion. He walked in the room. It was like the room just lit up, and his presence was just so. It was just like he attracts and he draws you right to him. And when he speaks, you just sit there, you're just listening, you're just mesmerized, and you're just listening to every word that he says, because you want to hear it. You want to, you know, just grab a hold, just become a sponge, and you begin to soak up everything and that he says, and it just spreads out to everyone. And so it's like we're all in just one spirit and one mind. So yes.
Absolutely. He's amazing, you know, and what I say is, for you founders that have not been in a room with him yet, wait till you're in a room with him. You think he's good on the webinar and you think he does good talking and you love him that way. Wait till you meet the guy in person. It's incredible.
Incredible.
What he puts off, the energy that he puts off is incredible. All right. Thank you, Joyce. I appreciate you.
Thank you so much, Joy, for coming on and share with us. And
thank you for having me.
I really appreciate that you come on and share this with us here. You know what, Milo and Joyce, you both have met Mr. Ash. I haven't, but I am so looking forward to be in the same room with him, asking him questions, right? Interviewing him. He has already accepted our invitation for us to do an interview with him in person, right? And also on the Zoom. He said we could do both. So it's very exciting, and we're good. I don't know how I'm gonna do it, Milo. I think I'm probably just shaking, and you know, like I don't know what to ask. So I have to
believe me. believe me, when you meet Ash, there's mm-hmm. nothing like meeting Ash. The passion, the love, you'll be just fine. You'll settle right down. He is amazing. He really is.
That's awesome. Yes. So I'm so looking forward to it.
All right. Well, we get to do it. That's a good thing. All right. Yeah. Next up, we got Mr. Curtis Davis. He's going to sing for us. Curtis, come on down.
Hey, before I try to sing, now I'm no Milo.
Whatever.
And I can't sing that good. And I used to tell him when I'd sing at church, Dad had called me up to sing, and he always called me up right before he'd preach. And I said, well, if anyone needs to go to the bathroom, now's the time to go, because you don't want to hear me sing. But my most memorable Christmas probably was when I was 5 years old in Upper Michigan, in Marquette, Michigan. And for Christmas that year, we didn't have nothing much. And we lived in the basement of the church. Mom would actually bathe us in a banana box with plastic in it, with a plastic trash bag in it. And so for that Christmas, we got one toy. I got a play trumpet, a plastic trumpet. Milo got a trombone, and my brother Corky got a saxophone. Now, it probably wasn't, I don't know, maybe 15 cents they spent on them back then. But that was something. And later on in life, I grew up, I played the trumpet. Milo played the trombone, and Cork played the saxophone. It was really something. But I'm going to try and sing Winter Wonderland. Let me see if I can get this thing to work. Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, the snow is glistening. It's a beautiful sight. We're happy tonight, walking in a winter wonderland. And gone away is a bluebird. Here to stay is a new bird. He sings a love song as he goes along, walking in a winter wonderland. And in the meadow we can build a snowman. We can pretend that he is Parson Brown. He'll say, are you married? We'll say, no, man. But you can do the job when you're in town. Well, later on we'll conspire. As we dream by the fire, to face unafraid the plans that we made, walking in a winter wonderland. In the meadow we can build a snowman, then pretend that he is Parson Brown. He'll say, are you married? We'll say, no, man. But you can do the job if you're in town. Well, later on we'll conspire, as we dream by the fire, to face unafraid the plans that we made, walking in a winter wonderland. We're walking in a winter wonderland. I said we're walking in a winter wonderland. Y'all have a very Merry Christmas, and everyone stay safe, please.
Good job, Curtis.
Good job. That was lovely, Curtis. Thank you for coming here and sharing with us that. Yes. Thank you so much, Curtis. All right, Kamau?
Hello.
Hello, Kat. Am I pronouncing your name correctly?
Yes, Kamau.
Kamau, yes, I remember.
Yes, thank you, Julie and Milo, and all the founder in here. It's a pleasure to be here today. About Christmas, I want to share a little bit about me and my family. Well, in my life, when my kids small, I won't able to give them, like, especially for Christmas, I won't able to give them what they want, but people always give it to me. So, so it's a blessing to be in ONPASSIVE. And I know that ONPASSIVE is a good company, and the especially I want to thank you, Mr. Ashmofari, for the love of ONPASSIVE for everyone around the world to have a chance to live again and to be able to give. So it's a blessing to be in ONPASSIVE business. I cannot say much, but just want to share a little bit for everyone that Christmas is very special. Thank you.
That was beautiful, beautiful cat, Mo. Let me see, am I on? Yeah, I guess I am. That was beautiful. Thank you very much for coming on and speaking to us. All right, this next guy coming up, me and him spent a few Christmases together. I'm sure our kids grew up together. We was at each other's house a lot, you know, probably in, I don't know what, Doc, 25 years or something. We had hung out together most of the time. So anyway, Dockery, I know Dockery can sing. So come on down, Mr. Wayne Dockery.
Hello, everybody. My brother Milo, my sister Julie, and the rest of my ONPASSIVE family. I'm really happy to be here. I'm excited to be here. And I got thinking about Christmas, and as I, when I was a child growing up, we really didn't have a whole lot. And in our Christmas stockings, we got walnuts, we got oranges, we got apples, and we got bananas. And my mom always said that was to show us that we always have something to eat. And I've been thinking about that. And there's a lot of darkness in the world right now. And I believe, I'm a firm believer, through ONPASSIVE, we can bring that darkness to light. You know, every time you walk into a dark room, the darkness overwhelms the room. If you turn, if you flip a switch, the light comes on. Every time, the light overcomes the darkness. We need to be that light to help overcome the darkness in the world and to be able to help everyone. You know, Christmas is about peace and love and goodwill to all. And I personally, I plan on giving to others. I know I didn't buy my kids a Christmas present. Their Christmas present is going to be an old founder's membership. And I think that's the best thing that I can give them. And I want to teach them to give also and help humanity and help the world. And I'm blessed to be here and in this position to do this. And I just want to let you all know that I love y'all.
Thank you so much, Wayne. We love you too. And thank you for calling me your sister. It melts my heart. Thank you so much. I appreciate you coming here and share this with us. We've always talked about Christmas, and I like to take this opportunity to share this with you. My Christmas story when I was young, as a lot of friends here that are actually listening to my Christmas, my story, in my story, I was born in a very wealthy family, but when the communists came, they took my dad away. I was at that time, I was only one year old. And when Christmas time come, imagine you have five little kids. My brother at that time was only 5 years old. My oldest brother was only 5 years old. And I was 1 year old, and I have, at that time, I have five brothers, and I'm the only girl in the family. And then my youngest brother was born probably about 7 months. So my mom was running around, had nothing. We had nothing. And the only thing that I could remember growing up in my Christmas time is we were cheerful. We were like five of us getting on the bed and singing, put the band together and singing to entertain my mom. But our tummy was hungry. We were hungry. We was very, very poor at that time, right? And when the communists came, they took everything, nothing left at home, right? And so I remember one Christmas, we were eating popcorns for dinner, you know, for our Christmas dinner. And then we hear something at the door. When my mom came out there, it was food for all of us. And it was just the angel just came and gave us that without, we didn't even know who did, who came. And so every Christmas to me growing up was about blessing, right? Joy, peace, love, but blessing was the biggest thing for me, right? I don't remember a Christmas where I have toys up to the roof, right? I'm sharing this is not because of I'm looking forward to gift or anything like that. I am the only Christmas gift that I ever wanted in my life. And I say this in my story, it's I just want to be an angel. I just want to go out there and change someone's life, because someone changed our life at that time. Someone changed my entire family at that time. And it's not happened once. It's happened every single time. And it happened in my life today as well. When I'm at the end of my pocket or my wallet or my bank account or whatever it is, something come up, some opportunity come up, something came up to my life. Why am I crying? Because I appreciate that past, that blessing that comes to me, right? And Christmas time is also the time for all of us to really think about what happened in the past year, what happened, you know, the sadness, the happiness and all of that. So every word that you can think of, blessing, love, joy, happiness, it's happened. So I'm crying here and I don't know if I can sing this song, but this song does mean something, right? It's called Hallelujah. It's a big song and I don't know if I can do it, but I'm in that time, that moment, and I'm just gonna do it. I'm gonna take all my nerve and I'm just gonna do it. And just really, if you haven't had the time to look at the meaning of the song or why the writer that wrote the song, it probably means something. So it's one of my favorite songs. I listen to this song all the time and I love it. And especially Christmas, I want to listen to it and sing it at the same time. So haven't sang for a while, but I'm going to do that.
I heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. But you who don't really care for music, Julia. Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor four and the major lift, the battle king composing Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Your faith is strong, but you need it proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty and the moonlight over the yard. She tied you to her kitchen chair. She broke your throat and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. But all I ever learned from love was how to shoot somebody. I'm sorry, I can't go any further. It's really stretching it.
Nice job, Julie.
I'm sorry, I can't go further. It's too big and...
That was beautiful, Julie. Absolutely beautiful. You've got a gorgeous voice, by the way. Very nice. Thank you.
Love you, Julie.
God bless you, Julie.
Beautiful, Julie. Thank you.
And, this
was really good.
That was awesome.
Loved it.
Thank you. It's really.
You are beautiful, Julie, inside and out.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much. If you haven't had a chance to look up the meaning of this song, it is. In the tradition, that's been a long time. And if you have a chance to look at this song, it means something as a Catholic. I think it's an Advent. It's a penance time. It's prepared for what is coming. So if you haven't had a chance to look at it or listen to that song, it's beautiful. I loved it so much, but I don't. That I can deliver as Alexander Boot, which is, or Cohen deliver that. So please look. I'm a mess, Milo. I muted my.
Hey, Julie, you're breaking up real bad. I don't know if it's just me or it's.
All right, I'm going to call Tony Monk. He has hand raised.
Same.
I think it's you, Milo. Am I breaking up or is it Milo again?
It's Milo, Julia. It's Milo.
Okay.
Yeah, I was just going to say that's a beautiful song. I remember that song, Katie Lang song, that song in the Olympics. I can't remember which Olympics it was. And it was absolutely phenomenal. And I've always loved that song. Always. And you can't mess that song up. You can't. I felt your heart. It was just beautiful, Julie, just gorgeous. And you have a beautiful voice. I love your voice. I wanted to let everybody know my little story, my Christmas story when I was a kid. I was born on an island called San Miguel, St. Michael's Island in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. And Punta Delgada was a small town that I was born in. And we were poor. We weren't wealthy. My dad would go and work in the States, in the United States, to bring us some American money because it was a lot. American money was a lot of money in Portugal, in the island of Azores, the Azores Islands where I was born. And I remember we used to put our shoes up on the counter, and that's how we got our presents in the morning, Christmas morning. My parents would put something inside our shoes. You know, my mom would do a lot of baking. We didn't have a lot of decorations, but we had a lot of love. And as far as I'm concerned, that's more important than anything, any gifts, or the best gift is the gift of love. You know, there's a lot of vulnerable people at this time of the year. There's also a lot of happy people as well. But we also have to, consider the fact that there's homeless people out there that have no one, you know, and they're crying. They're crying from the inside. They may not show it on the outside, but the best thing that we can do for them is to smile and wish them a Merry Christmas, and you know, or even tell them that we love them. We have a beautiful group of people here in ONPASSIVE, and I love this family because this is all about heart. When I first listened to Ash's videos, you know, the videos I'm talking about, the two videos, I didn't hear what Ash was saying. I didn't hear his voice. You know what I heard? I heard his heart. I heard his heart. And that's what did it for me, because I knew at that point that it was authentic and genuine. and that's what I fell in love with. And since then, I mean, look at where we are today. It's, you know, we're very fortunate to be here. We really are. And we're going to make a big difference in the world in so many ways. There's a lot of poverty out there. Joyce, thank you so much for being part of that part of it. Chris has a huge heart. He started the Angels. And that man, I tell you, he's all about heart. And it's all about heart, really, in ONPASSIVE. When I first came in, I came in with the business mindset. And then I realized, you know what, that's not what we're really all about here. And that's not really what we really care. We're more about therapeutic and helping each other out in a heartful way. And that's beautiful. My family, like I said, is 4,000 miles away. I don't get to see them every year. And because of the pandemic, it's been hard for anyone to see their family. So I'm going to do my best to do what I can do on my own here. But I'll just plug into whatever I can plug in to put a smile on my face. Thank you, Milo. And thank you, Julie, for having me here. Putting this together for us. This is absolutely phenomenal. And it's very therapeutic.
Thank you, Tony. Thank you. All right. I'd like to tell a little story that I got. I was thinking, as Julie was saying, and you know, as Kurt told the story, I've been up, I've been down, I've been all around. I've had money, I've had times when I didn't have money, you know. But I've been so blessed in my life, and my daughter also. I just want to tell this little story. Peggy always was one. She loved to give, and Peggy would always get with the girls. She'd say, "Now, girls, come on, let's walk around the snowbank." Said, "You never know." Said, "People drop money, and the snowplow pushes it up," and she would find money, you know. And so, Jessica was in the store one day, and she was. She said there was an older guy there with. She thought it was his grandson, And the grandson was wanting a pair of shoes, and he didn't have the money. He said, "Oh," he said, "buddy," he said, "I'd like to get them." He said, "But I just don't have that kind of money, you know." And Jessica said, "Man, Dad, if I would have had the money, I would have gave it to him, you know." And at the time, myself personally, I was struggling, you know, and my other daughter was struggling, and so Jessica went outside, and she said she walked around the snowbank, and sure enough, she looked down and there was $100 bill laying down there. Well, I'm thinking to myself, man, it'd be nice because, you know, she's going to send me some or give me some. But you know what she did? She took that $100 bill and she walked back in the store. She found that older gentleman and she just said, "I just walked up and I said, here, let this help you out." And she gave him that $100 bill. Now, remember, I'm struggling and myself, I'm thinking, man, would have been nice if she'd have gave some of that to me. I didn't say that to her because I didn't raise her that way, right? But I'll never forget the day before I had went to McDonald's and I had no money. I mean, I was broke and I was going through my change in my car to get enough money to buy a hamburger, you know? And I was really struggling. And so when she told me this story, I said, "Jess, that is beautiful, man. Man, that's great. What a heart, you know, you have and stuff." And do you know, the next morning, I walked out to my car and I got in my car. There was two $20 bills sitting in where that change was. Now, I know those two $20 bills wasn't there because I had to dig for coins to get a hamburger the day before. But, you know, that's the way things work, you know. When you give, a lot of times it comes back to you. I don't have no idea where that is. My car was locked up. I have no idea where that money come from, but I know there was two $20 bills in there that wasn't there in there the day before. So I love it. I love telling stories like that because it, so many times when you give, it comes back to you. It will come back to you, you know, big time. So anyway, that's my story. And let's see, I did see Mr. Jeffrey Morlock came on, and I know Jeffrey has a song for us, I'm sure. Jeffrey, are you ready to come on and sing us one?
Yay!
Jeffrey, are you in the house? Jeffrey Morlock is in the house.
Yay! Hi, Jeffrey.
I am so sorry, guys. I meant to be here earlier. I got a call from Corinne, and she said she's doing a series of interviews. Would I interview? I had to laugh. I don't know why you want to interview me, because I'm not that whatever, but 2 hours later, like me. So that's why I didn't get to anyway. God bless all of you. Hello, hello. It's good to see each and every one of you today. And Julie, I love that. I did get on in time to see you sing. And I love that song. I agree with Tony that song is one that just it tears me up when I get going with it too. So do I have a song? Well, if you guys could probably stomach going through a little a cappella, I've got a song that I do enjoy. It is a Christmas song.
Absolutely.
You may have heard of O Come Emmanuel.
Mm-hmm.
And it just complicates things if you put music in it. So I guess I'll try to sing it. I mean, I'm not going to do all the verses because I think there's like six of them, five or something, but I can do a couple of them if that's all right.
Absolutely, please.
All right, let me sit up. I got to get to breathe here. I'm glad Cedric is not. All right, let's try this. O Come Emmanuel. It's like, let's see. O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel that mourns in lonely exile year. Until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou rod of Jesse free, thine own from Satan's tyranny. From death of hell thy people save, and give them victory o'er the grave. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. And I'll stop there.
Beautiful, Jeffrey. I love that song. And every time before Christmas, when you go to church, that song was a song that start the whole mass. So love it. Thank you so much, Jeffrey, for jumping on.
And I've got a granddaughter, if I can grab her, she just got a new karaoke thing. I bet I can sing Jingle Bells or Rudolph.
Do it. Let's have her. Come on down.
I'll have to go find her.
Okay. We got a few more minutes, so bring her on.
Yes. Would love that. You know, I wanna share this story. Last night, right? We were driving home last night, right after Ron and Lynn. I wanted to spend some time with my daughter. So
we took, I took my daughters out. We went and had some very, very nice Mediterranean food. As we drove home, closer to home, we saw a gentleman lay down right, you know, on the floor, right next to the curb. And we didn't realize, you know, it was someone's. And then one of my daughters said, "Mom, look at that person laying there." And I saw him, but I didn't want to say anything. I want my daughter to start it, right? So we passed by him. And then my daughter said, "Mom," my oldest one, she said, "Mom, you should get, we should turn around. We should turn around and check on that person." I said, "Are you sure? Do you feel that it's safe to do that?" And she goes, "Maybe we should just call the police." And at that time, we picked up the phone, we called the police, we letting them know that. And then we turned around to see if it actually the person laying there, because you might say something, you might call the police and it was something wrong, right? So we turned around and then we saw that person still there. So we called the police back and we said that person was there. But the story I'm telling you is yesterday, last night at that time, it was about 50 degrees here in California. And it's cold. I mean, for a Californian, it is cold. But it has to have, for my daughter to say it, it's big for me, because, you know, it's not just about the gift. It's not just about the things that they receive, but the paying attention about the surrounding that she is seeing yesterday. I think it was big for me. And to me, every time when there's cold, no, snow, storm, I always ask, and this is my prayer to God every time. I said, "God, please send the Holy Spirit and bring the warmth and weather to them, to the people that have no home, to the people that has no roof." So that's my prayer every single time when winter comes. Right. And I know Milo has a song. You might not, the white paper that you said, Milo, could you please sing that for us? Because it really, the ones that you wrote, the ones that the white paper, I think.
Oh, pretty paper.
Pretty paper, yes.
Pretty paper.
Sing that to us?
Yeah, let me, I'll have to sing along with the track that I got because I don't have it anyplace else, but let me try to find it. Give me just a second.
All right, that song is very meaningful to Milo as well, and he told the story. And so while we're waiting for Milo, I know John Barilla is here. And yesterday I heard him sing something. He had a really good voice. John, I'm gonna bring you up because I don't know if you're ready or if you want to, but please give us some song or a song.
Well, hello, I'm not ready to sing. But I am a singer, but I'm not ready to sing at the moment. I'm just enjoying listening to everyone else and kind of singing along in the background with myself if I know the song. But I'm just not prepared at the moment to do it. I'm so happy, you know, and it tends to be when I'm always in the background on so many of these webinars, and when I even come to your show, and I rarely will speak, but every once in a while, someone says, "Oh, there's John Barilla." So I'm happy to come on and say, you know, Merry Christmas and happy holidays to everybody. This has been great. I love listening to all of you. Julie, you got me. You know, like I said, when you were singing your song, I got a little emotional myself. And I'm very happy with where we're at with our wonderful business, and I'm just excited about that, but I really don't have much else to say, and I hope you'll let me beg off, or, you know, I'm hoping for the day when maybe, I don't know about O-Connect doing this, but the one thing about these Zoom platforms, I'm actually in the theater, I'm a singer, and I perform a lot, and on Zoom, and a lot on the internet, you can't really have duets or choruses singing together when they're all in their different places, because everybody has to be in the same place. I'm hoping that, I don't know about O-Connect discovering the solution to this, because this is like a problem beyond the particular platform like Zoom. I wish we could solve the problem of the delay that happens when you are on these, and it would be so wonderful to have all of the folks here today to be able to come on and sing a Christmas song together, but you can't really do that because it doesn't sync properly. I'm just hoping for the day that we can do that, because I've actually been involved in a couple of shows that should be musicals, where if you're singing as the solo singer, it's great to sing on here, just like you folks have been singing. But if you put a chorus of people, but they're not all in the same place, oh, you can't do it. It's like when we unmute our mics to say goodbye at the end of these webinars, they say, everybody unmute your mics. And half the people, you can't hear because their mic isn't picking it up and it's delaying it. It does sound fun because everybody's voice does come up, but that's an example of that delay that you can't really, you know. Anyway, I'm going on about that and I don't know why, but I love everybody. I'm glad to be here. And maybe if somebody else sings again, I'll sing in the background here on my own, but I'm a little bit too shy today to sing after listening to everybody else. Everybody sounds so wonderful.
Hey, John, I tell you, the first thing I asked Ash when I met him was exactly that question. Because I said, I want to be in Nashville. I want to be playing my piano and singing and have a drummer in New York and have a bass player in California. Can I do that? And he looked at me with a twinkle in his eye and he says, no.
No. I was hoping he would say, well, maybe we'll be able to get that techno.
But listen what he said. He said, no, it's not available now because of the speed of the internet. It's called I can't remember the name now, but anyway, that's where it lags. Okay. But he said, it is coming. He said, and as soon as it comes on passive, we'll have it. And that was music to my ear right there.
Yeah.
He had me, man. He hooked me because that's what I've been wanting all along, you know?
It'll be great. Yeah.
It's beautiful when you can do that, when you can talk, but even like right now, if someone has their mic on and you're trying to sing, you'll see it go out. If they cough, it picks theirs up and it drops you off, you know? And so, you know, it's like you said, but it would be wonderful if you could have a whole choir, man. I would love it. That's what I would love to do today.
Yeah. And listen, I may come on and sing here sometime on your show. I'd love to come on sometime. Like I say, I'm actually a performer, but I'm kind of backward, bashful. It's like why I'm so involved with us here in the business. But like I say, I'm in a lot of places, a lot of webinars, but I don't often present my personality on the screen here. And when I do, it's a lot shorter than what I'm doing right now. But I think I will at some point. I'd love to come on and maybe sing something, or I hope I don't have to wait till next Christmas. But I'm just not up to it at the moment. I'm, you know.
Absolutely. The way I do it is I plug in a karaoke song or a track, or if I'm myself, and as long as the music is right there with you, it will come across fine, you know, and then you just play one and sing with it, you know. So that's what I'm fixing to do right now. I'll do Pretty Paper. Julie, okay. I'm not sure I got the one with I'm going to play this one. I'm not sure if it's got the words that I wrote or not. If not, you can go onto my Facebook and see it, you know, but I'll do this one real quick for you guys.
All right, go ahead.
It's called Pretty Paper. All right, here we go. Pretty Paper. Pretty ribbons of blue, wrap your presents to your darling from you. Pretty pencils to write I love you. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons. Go by hand, downtown shoppers, Christmas is nigh. There he sits, all alone on the sidewalk, hoping that you won't pass him by. Stop, better not, I'm much too busy.
I'm in a hurry. You know how time flies. In the distance, a ringing of laughter. And in the midst of the laughter, he cries. Pretty papers, pretty ribbons of blue. Wrap your presents to your darling from you. Pretty pencils to write, I love you. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue. As I sit here today with my family, many presents there under our but my mind goes back to the sidewalk, wondering if he has something to eat. Then I think should have stopped, could have helped him, but was busy. So busy that day, could have said, he said, how are you doing? To help to rise on his day. Pretty paper, pretty ribbon. Wrap your presents to your darling from you. Pretty pencils to write, I love you. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue. So I think I will go out there and find him. Maybe drop him a dollar or two. Just because he has a tough life, don't mean he don't want Christmas too. So my heart really goes out there to him, especially this time of the year. So let's think of the less fortunate and offer to bring good cheer. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue. Wrap your presents to your darling from you. Say these words to someone brand new. Merry Christmas and God bless you. Oh, Merry Christmas and God bless you.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Thank you, Milo.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Thank you so much. Very meaningful song. All right. We do have about less than 15 minutes left. So I'd like to bring on Lystra. Lystra, if you would please unmute your mic.
Hello.
Hey, Lystra.
Hi, everyone. Milo, that was amazing. Oh, my goodness. I was going to do All Holy Night, but now that you've sang that, I can't think about anything else but that pretty picture, pretty paper.
No, do All Holy Night.
Do it.
Okay, now we did this at my church every Christmas Eve. I just love it, okay? Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt his worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, from yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel's voices. Oh, night divine, oh, night when Christ was born. Oh, night divine, oh, night, oh, night divine.
Only one verse. Thank you.
Beautiful, beautiful voice and beautiful song, Lystra. Thank you so much. Love it. Thank you, Lystra. All right, back to you, Milo. You're muted, Milo. I muted your mic when Lystra was saying.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Sorry about that. Hey, we have one more coming up, and then we'll close it down. We got, Trevor Peters coming up. Unless your granddaughter is ready. Trevor Peters, come on down.
I tried to get her to Milo. She wouldn't do it.
Okay, no problem. Trevor, come on down, then we'll close this thing down.
I found some service. Yay. I'm so glad I got in that, fell into that. I got to hear your song, Milo, and Lister. You guys are both beautiful sounding voices. just to let everybody know, we are in a transition right now. We're moving from Phoenix, Arizona to Central Florida there. I'm going to be about 45 minutes from Ashland. So I'm really excited about that. Glad got to catch you guys here at the tail end of this thing. So proud to be a founder. And man, there's many great days ahead of us, aren't there? You guys have a blessed Merry Christmas. I'm sure we'll see you on a couple more webinars before it's all said and done with. But I'm going to hop off for now before I lose service again and give somebody else a chance to get the win.
All right. Thank you, Trevor. And that completes the show for today. We want to thank you all for coming, the ones that sang, the ones that talked. It was a wonderful time. I love listening to the stories. I love seeing all of you. I love every one of you. It's been a wonderful day for me.
Hey, Milo.
Yeah.
I am so sorry to bother you, but I just thought of something. I'm looking at Lynn here, and Lynn had a show last night, and my granddaughter was here, and I didn't realize that my granddaughter had done a picture, Lynn, that she wanted me to show you, and I said, it's done, it's over, and now look, there you are, so I went and got it, but I don't know if you guys can see it, but she wrote all the names on there that she saw on that screen. and it's a rainbow of ONPASSIVE, and your name is right in the middle, somewhere. Aww. Right in.
Oh, what a sweetheart.
Yeah, so she was all upset, but at least you guys, I get to see her, show her now. Yep, they've seen it. So, Milo, I appreciate that. Thank you, Lynn, so much.
Thank you for sharing that.
Thank you, Jeff. Thank you. Thank you, Jeffrey. All right. So that concludes the show for today. Julie, I'm going to send it back to you because you do it the best, closing it down. I know you got a song you want to play for us or whatever, but Merry Christmas to all of you. I think next week is Christmas, right? There'll be no show. Next week will be Christmas, Julie, no show. So at least that's what we're planning on right now.
As you can see, wait, there's some mic on somewhere.
I got it. It was probably great.
Okay, thank you so much, everyone, for being here. We do hope that you stay safe and stay healthy in this season. And really, truly, I'd like you to think about what the next song that I'm going to play. I do feel that what we have been gone through the past 3 years with ONPASSIVE, there is time when we feel scared. There's time when we're not sure. There's time, I mean, I'm not speaking on behalf of myself, but I do this hear and see the feeling of everyone's going through. So when you listen to this next song coming up, please mute your mic, Milo. please just kind of go through the journey that you have gone through and feel this individual that is talking on this particular song. The song is called Breath of Heaven by Amy Grant. And if you looked up that song and if you hear that song, you will feel the scariness of Mary going through and being carried Jesus inside. And I do understand there are some of us are not celebrating this, but just feeling that you're carrying a baby inside and you're not sure what to expect it. And it's just really lovely. So before I play this song, I like to say, you are all loved in the Julie and Milo show, particularly, and ONPASSIVE as well. If you ever, ever have a moment that you feel alone, you feel lonely, you can reach out to any one of us, especially Milo and I. We'll be there for you. If you are going through the holiday and you feel that no one cares or feel lonely, please remove those thoughts out of your mind. Please, because you are not lonely and you're not alone. We all are here for you. All right, I've got 6 minutes and the song is about 5-something minutes. So I'm gonna stop and I'm gonna play that song for you. Please enjoy.
Many warm nights, cold and weary, with a babe inside, and I wonder what I'll do. Holy Father, you have come. Thank you.
Did you learn to love me? If the wiser one should have had my place, but I offer all I am for the mercy of your plan. Help me be strong.
Thank you so much, everyone, for being here, for coming to the Julie and Milo show today to celebrate Christmas with us, the season greetings with us. Thank you so much. We hope that you have a safe Christmas celebrating with your family. Have a safe season of celebration, and please stay well, stay healthy. Next year is going to be a big old Christmas show in a big old room for all of us to be together. Thank you so much. Have a great one. Good night from Orange County, California.
Good night from Nashville.
Good night.
Good night from Canada.
Good night from Alberta, Canada. Thanks, Julie and Milo. Great show. Good Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas to one and all.
Hopefully see you tomorrow.
Merry Christmas.
Happy holidays.
Happy holiday. Merry Christmas.
It's a great webinar. So glad I didn't miss it.
Enjoy your
Good night, everyone.
Goodbye, everybody. God bless you.
You gotta take time off to your business. All I can do is give you guys a bye, Julie. And
Linda and Julie,
love you. My love, we will all be making my dreams. I know these guys, I'm gonna come.
Share the love.
Chia sẻ tình yêu.
Sharek al hub.
Teile die Liebe.
Time of peace is coming. Everyone should sing. Better life we're loving. ONPASSIVE will bring.
Anything you need now is in one place. Fullness waiting to be yours. Nothing less than grace. Close your eyes, spread your wings, make your dreams come true. Share the joy, share the love, total freedom comes to you. Close your eyes, spread your wings, make your dreams come true. You are not alone, ONPASSIVE is your selfless love. Join to make a paradise on earth with us together,
and take care of each other forever and forever. Close your eyes, spread your wings, make your dreams come true. Share the joy, share the love, total freedom comes to you. Close your eyes, spread your wings,
spread your wings,
make your dreams come true.
Dreams come true.
You are not alone, ONPASSIVE is your home.
It's here to stay on passive. There's just no better way. Listen to the Julie and the Milo show, cause so then you can be the very first to know. On passive, it's here to stay. Julie and Milo.